The sun comes up on a bright spring morning, and the blossom on the cherry is the first to appear. As the day breaks open, the air is tinged with the sound of tractor engines rumbling in the valley. Having already ploughed most of the small plots, Tona has come down from the top of the hill, and with a harrow in tow starts turning the topsoil and making a fine tilth ready for things to grow. Sunk between each undulation, small irregular plots are eked out. Tona is a friend to everyone, and after harrowing our new field, moves on to that of the salad woman, who thanks him in the customary manner with a glass of homemade plum brandy. These small rituals are part of the remnants of a community. From there he moves on to the field belonging to the third sister, and following that, a whole succession of others. In these fields a narrow selection of produce will be grown, sweet corn and potatoes, and marrow, much of which will be fodder for the animals. Elsewhere, Tona has turned his attention to a small clearing in the heart of his wood, and the plough here makes deep drills for seeding potatoes. Maritza and Mima lay the potatoes in the trenches and cover them up. Beyond this, the lower undulation is being made ready for corn. It is a demanding job, and the good earth sometimes disgorges huge stones in the wake of the plough. Stones that could so easily break the ploughshare. Thank you. By late afternoon back in the valley, others are responding to the warming soil. Our new neighbour, Tamara, plants onions and carrots. While a little way off on a strip of land behind Bara's house, Bieber covers the seeds on the staple of the family table. In our new field, raised beds have been constructed, and likewise our expectations are raised that this year will be a fruitful one.